Well, blessings. Welcome to a new day of study of God's Word together. We're continuing in our current series taken from the book of Esther entitled For Such a Time as This. Now, as we begin, let's take a look at today's scripture passage taken from Esther chapter 1 verses 13 to 22. Here we read these words. The king consulted the wise men who understood the times, for it was his normal procedure to confer with experts in law and justice. The most trusted ones were Karshena, Shethar, Admatha, Tarshish, Meres, Marcena, and Memucan. They were the seven officials of Persia and Media who had personal access to the king and occupied the very highest positions in the kingdom. Now the king asked, according to the law, what should be done with Queen Vashti, since she refused to obey King Ahasuerus' command that was delivered by the eunuchs? Memucan said in the presence of the king and his officials, Queen Vashti has wronged not only the king, but all the officials and the peoples who are in every one of King Ahasuerus' provinces. For the queen's action will become public knowledge to all the women and cause them to despise their husbands and say, King Ahasuerus ordered Queen Vashti brought before him, but she did not come. Before this day is over, the noble women of Persia and Media who hear about the queen's act will say the same thing to all the king's officials, resulting in even more contempt and fury. If it meets the king's approval, he should personally issue a royal decree. Let it be recorded in the laws of Persia and Media so that it cannot be revoked. Vashti is not to enter King Ahasuerus' presence, and her royal position is to be given to another woman who is more worthy than she. The decree the king issues will be heard throughout his vast kingdom, so all the women will honor their husbands from the least to the greatest. Now the king and his counselors approved the proposal, and he followed Memucan's advice. He sent letters to all the royal provinces, to each province in its own script, and to each ethnic group in its own language, that every man should be master of his own house and speak in the language of his own people. Now, as we begin to set the stage for today's study, it's important that we go back one verse in order to jog our memory of what has necessitated these drastic measures that we find the king is taking in this passage. So back in Esther chapter 1, verse 12, we read, Queen Vashti refused to come at the king's command that was delivered by his eunuchs, and the king became furious and his anger burned within him. Now, as we move into our passage for today, we find that King Ahasuerus, he's stumped by the queen's refusal to follow his direct order. And not knowing what to do, he turns to his seven most trusted advisors. These men most likely turn to astrology and divination and other forms of witchcraft to determine their king's course of response to the queen's actions, because that was a common practice among the pagans in that day. So Memucan, one of the seven, argued that Queen Vashti had sinned against all the nobles and all the people of the kingdom, as we read in verses 16 through 18. And he went on and he expressed his fear that the queen's action will become public knowledge to all the women and will cause them to despise their husbands, as we read in verse 17. And then these women would say, King Ahasuerus ordered Queen Vashti brought before him, but she did not come. The outcome of this would be a show of disrespect among all the women for their husbands and their male leaders, resulting in more contempt and fury, as verse 18 declares. Memucan had taken a single occurrence of disrespect between a husband and a wife and had escalated it into an empire-wide crisis. Memucan's response, it served to feed the king's growing fear in this situation, and it caused the king to go ahead and accept the advice of this advisor, resulting in what would become a somewhat drastic royal decree. Memucan then advised the king to issue a royal decree that all women must respect their kings. He further emphasized the king's power and authority, reminding him that the laws of Persia and Media could never be repealed. Such a drastic response seems to us to be illogical and even ironic, because what the king had intended to do to squelch here only became more widely known. By sending out this royal decree across the empire, he was personally making Vashti's insubordination known to all women. What he was trying to prevent, he has caused his own self. And through these acts, we are also given an insight into how the Persian monarchy operated in its lust for a complete control of all things. Now, as the scenes of this story continue to unfold, we're going to witness how God is going to work through this irrevocable law in order to use a woman who is also a wife to save his people. Have you ever seen people in power act out of fear to protect their position? Perhaps you've even done it yourself. Fear can create a very negative influence in our lives if we're not careful. If you are faced with a difficult decision that needs to be made, I want you to consider how you can act not from a place of fear, but rather with a complete and a total trust in God. You know, power can be used for good, but it can also be used for evil. Be careful always how you wield the power that you have been given. Trust more in God than you ever trust in your power. Until next time.